Everybody, welcome back tonight. Brian Keating alongside Carson Cunningham, another edition of Crashing the Boards. Right in the middle of summer, you wouldn't think there's so many things going on. But for the Oklahoma City Thunder, not in the playoffs, but Tuesday NBA draft lottery. Yeah. We'll find out whether they draft 1, 2, or 3 or all the way back at 14. As you look towards the draft, and it certainly will depend if they pick in the top three or at the end. But
those are long odds.
Those are long odds, yeah. Where are you seeing the Thunder, and what do they need the most as we look forward towards the draft?
Well, I think it's time to admit the Jeremy Lamb experiment has not worked. Yep. I think it's going to be Lamb chopped this offseason. They need to start grooming a young shooting guard who can shoot and play a little defense. Now, he's not going to play next year. Andre Robertson, you got Anthony Morrow, Deion Waiters. They got enough guys at the shooting guard position, but they really need to start grooming a Jeremy Lamb replacement.
Do they have enough guys at the shooting guard position? Because I think they actually need shooting. Yep. I think they need guys who can make shots. And if you look at the final four teams left playing in the NBA playoffs, they're the four teams that made the most three-pointers in the playoffs. So that tells you if you can make threes and you can shoot the basketball, you can win in the playoffs. It's sort of a little bit different than the way basketball, you know, we always think big guys. But shooters and Oklahoma City, you just can't have too many of those guys. Even somebody coming off the bench, I don't think you're going to find a starter. But somebody else who can make shots with Morrow and Kevin as really knockdown kinds of guys.
Yeah, I think Billy Donovan's going to like Anthony Morrow, though. He didn't get enough minutes last year.
Doubt.
He can fill it up. Once he got to play a lot, he started hitting a lot of shots, so he'll be big.
NBA draft lottery's Tuesday. Obviously, we'll find out where they draft. But maybe we're burying the headline, right?
Yes, we are.
Russell Westbrook will represent the Thunder on Tuesday night. I have to imagine his wardrobe selections will be a sight to see. So
in New York City.
Yeah, in New York City. So Russell Westbrook going to look like how?
He's going to look Russ-diculous. You know, he saves his biggest ensembles, his most wild outfits for the bigger stage. You know, playoff time, he would come
to
press conferences decked out in red frames and fish on his shirts. I mean, he's going to go above and beyond, and he's going to be wearing his Westbrook frames, no doubt.
Russell Westbrook plays with all energy and all heart, and he lays it out there, right?
Oh, yeah.
But it's going to be intense. I can guarantee you it's going to be intense. But it'll be a sight to see. And the Thunder, look, it is long odds for them to get up in the top three. But Russell Westbrook's going to make a statement in his few minutes of fame here in New York City.
He can make a statement without saying anything. You just got to put the camera on him. Of course, the camera won't be on him very long. They're going to get the 14th pick, no doubt.
Yeah, no question. Let's do talk a little bit about the playoffs.
Okay.
Clippers
kind
Rockets.
Kind of depressing without the Thunder.
It is, yeah, I know. Clippers Rockets. Clippers had this thing. I mean, it was over, right? Game six, a 19-point lead in the third quarter, and then here come the Rockets. All the way back, they win the series on Sunday. Just describe this series and how it played out, and sort of, it's stunning.
Well, I know one loser this series was Thunder fans, having to watch these two teams play. Just probably the two most despised teams OKC plays. You know, Clippers like to fashion themselves as Lob City. You got to change that to Choke City. I mean, we thought we had seen it all when they blew Game 5 against the Thunder. To blow Game 6 at home to the Rockets in the fashion that they did, then not even really put up a fight in Game 7, it's a monumental choke, even by Clippers standards.
That's strong. The Clippers are kind of who we thought they were in a lot of ways. They are losers!
Oh,
they are
strong.
Losers!
Oh my God.
Game 5 in Oklahoma City last year, they had OKC beat. Chris Paul was brutal in the last 45 seconds. They somehow find a way to lose. In Game 6, they were scared to win.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what happened. They didn't win because they are losers. Chris Paul, hey, I'm not calling him a loser, but look, guy never wins anything. His team, we can't say, doesn't have talent. They have plenty of talent. And once again, what do they do?
You thought Choke City was strong?
Losers
is really strong.
They are losers, no doubt about it. Final thing. Eastern Conference Finals,
mm-hmm.
You got the Atlanta Hawks and you have the Cleveland Cavaliers, 1-2. How would you describe as we look forward to game one this week?
LeBron's going to be saying king me. I mean, he's probably already looking past Atlanta to the NBA Finals. This is their series. Atlanta had a great regular season, but when they struggle with the Wizards, they let old man Paul Pierce rein in some buzzer beaters against them. Look, it's a nice showing by Atlanta getting to the Conference Finals, but it's all about LeBron at this point.
It's all about LeBron. LBJ, I think they probably win in 5 games. LeBron's too good. He'll be in the finals one more time playing the Golden State Warriors, right?
He's hitting buzzer beaters. Oh, they're playing the Warriors, no doubt. Warriors looking like they're going to win the title.
All right, that's all the time we have. We'll be right back.